I identify as a biological anthropologist who has research interests in bioarchaeology and forensic anthropology. And the intellectual baseline for both of those disciplines is osteology, or the study of the skeleton. As a bioarchaeologist, we work with people who have been deceased typically for 100 years or longer to learn about what their lives may have been like. And we do that via studying their skeletal remains. As a forensic anthropologist, we are studying people who have been more recently deceased with slightly different goals, typically to maybe to help get somebody identified, or if somebody is already identified, but maybe there's been some trauma on their bones that might have happened around the time of death. So trying to elucidate those for law enforcement and the medical examiner. When we think about, you know, bioarchaeology, there are a lot of bioarchaeologists today, and really the direction of the field is to demonstrate how learning about past peoples is relevant for people who are living today. Social conditions can create biological conditions. And so trying to understand if we can make those conclusions for the past, then we can make that relevant for people who are living today. And it might enable us to also be agents of social change, so that we can say, well, we're not just, you know, looking at, you know, the remains of people who have been dead for hundreds or thousands of years. And this actually has relevance for people who are living today. We know that people who are impoverished, for example, we know that people who experience racism, who are discriminated against, that they have very serious biological consequences of that. And so if we can demonstrate that for the past, then that might help us to influence social change for the present as well. When they started exhuming E15 and the remains were revealed and started cleaning the remains and could see those areas of growth and development super clear, that was just a really good feeling to be able to tell the Fridays and be able to tell, you know, everybody who was there, this is Little Plume. My work in Carlisle has been, it's not work, it's a vocation, but it's work that really will reverberate through the generations for the families. To shine a light on it, a light that really has not yet been shown, and it's really only recently that a sort of a task force to start to look at the impact that residential schools have had on tribes and families and really the fabric of the entire nation. And just overall, it's just been, it's really been a life-changing experience for me, not only professionally, but personally as well. My name is Elizabeth DiGangi, and I am an associate professor of anthropology here at Binghamton University.